Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 7th Annual Engaged in Excellence Awards, sponsored by the Elmbrook Education Foundation. Please welcome your host, Chris Thompson.
Hey, thank you for that warm welcome. For a second there, I had a flashback to my last five school board presentations. Now, some of you may say, well, you brought it on yourself, Chris, by wearing that jersey, but you need to know that we always try to incorporate recent events into this award show. And when I heard TV was coming back, I knew we had to run with it. You know, there are many things that Tom and I have in common. Some people have told Tom that in certain poses, we look alike. We both have receding hairlines. We're both married to supermodels. Hey, I hope Giselle's not watching, or she might take that personally. And after last year's show, some people called on me to retire, just like Tom. But just like Tom, I'm back for another year, and I'm looking forward to hosting tonight's fantastic awards event. Now, typically, when preparing for this show, we draw inspiration from the Oscars. Well, maybe not so much this year. So changing subjects, some people ask me, how can I be so calm on stage in front of millions of people in the theater and watching our live stream? The secret is, I carry this lucky rock in my pocket during the show. In fact, some refer to it as Chris's rock. That'll be the only Oscar reference you hear tonight.
Excuse me, Chris.
Oh, hey, everyone. Mark Hansen, superintendent. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Chris. Seems opening monologue may need a little help.
Wait. Dr. Hansen, was it that number 12 who said he was coming back for another year? That's what got people excited?
Correct.
Shoot.
Of course it was number 12.
I really missed the mark on that one.
Chris, why don't you take a moment to regroup as I introduce our first tribute. Our retirees have committed their life's work to our students and community, and we start tonight's awards celebration with a video about growing up in Elmbrook.
When I grow up, I want to be like Brookfield Central's Marissa Roth. Did you know that Marissa advocated to the WIAA for a girls' state wrestling tournament, which was held for the first time this year, and she was the first girls' state champion wrestler ever for the Elmbrook schools. That's inspirational.
When I grow up, I want to be like Brookfield Central's Ben Kim and Kevin Nim.
Ben Kim is a national merit finalist, and
Kevin served as key club governor for all high school community service clubs in Wisconsin. They both are graduating at the top of their class. How awesome is that?
When I grow up, I want to be like Brookfield East's Manal Nazir. She is a Science Olympiad Team President National Merit Finalist, and she participated in a five-week research program last summer creating a solution to a real healthcare problem. Amazing!
When I grow up, I want to be like my guidance counselor, Miss McKenna, because she's always there for all of her students and she encourages them to do their best.
When I grow up, I want to be just like my kindergarten teacher, Mrs. Radosevich. This is because I just want to give my students the same experience that she gave me when I was younger. And she just has such a positive learning environment and she gets to know each and every one of her students and it really shows.
When I grow up, I want to be like Miss Enger because she wants all of her students to succeed and she truly cares about them.
When I grow up, I want to be like Mr. Seeger because of how well he connects to students, and I think you have to connect to students in order to teach.
When I grow up, I really like to be like my choir teacher, Mrs. Depke, because she's always really comforting, and you always feel like you can talk with her and have a lot of fun in the classroom.
When I grow up,
I want to be wise and fearless like Cheryl Pyle.
I hope to be intentional and well-spoken, just like Norm Andrews.
I'd like to be thoughtful and reflective like Jenny Slonek.
When I grow up, I want to be patient and sophisticated.
I want to be kind, caring, fun, generous, and dedicated.
I want to be fun-loving and generous.
I want to be compassionate, caring, creative, as well as an amazing cook. Just like Peggy Ordonez.
Just like Honoré Shiro.
Like Dan Paese.
Like Wendy Ruland.
When I grow up, I'd like to be upstanding with a strong body and strong mind.
Dedicated.
Optimistic.
Kind-hearted.
And retired.
When I grow up, I want to be a good mentor like Kevin Allen.
Just like Huel Sanders.
Like Karen Lampe.
I want to be genuine and dedicated. Cheerful and positive.
I want to be caring. And dedicated.
I want to be charismatic
and bougie like Tom Duran.
As Anna Marie Feldmeyer.
Just like Bobby Bunker.
Like Sherry Nikolowski.
I want to be rich and famous like Leslie Stolberg.
I want to be as compassionate, genuine, dedicated, and able to see the best in everyone and everything. Just like my teammate, mentor, and friend, Mrs. Sandy Rasmussen.
When I grow up, I hope to be as dedicated and passionate as Jenny Speck.
I want to be sassy and passionate, just like Jean Nagel.
I want to be trustworthy, respectful, and gracious during stressful times, just like my boss, nurse Kathy Adams.
When I grow up, I hope to be kind and the most positive person in the world, just like Corey Hartman.
As you grow up in the Elmbrook schools, you will find that you can be anything you want to be.
Your teachers will be amazing, and the opportunities that you will have will exceed your expectations.
You'll be inspired by your friends and supported by our community in your pursuit of excellence.
And most importantly, you will always know that you are loved.
Please join me in thanking the members of our retiring class of 2022. Thank you. Thank you. Kevin, Taffy, no, stay here. Cheryl, Huel, Karen, Tom, Peggy, Honore, Dan, Jenny, Wendy, Corey. You've impacted the lives of thousands of students and staff members as they've grown up in the Elmbrook schools. On behalf of our entire community, thank you for sharing your passion for education and our students for so many years. And congratulations on your retirement. Ladies and gentlemen, our class of 2022 retirees. Kevin? There you go. Thank you. Be careful. What a great year we've had in Elmbrook. Despite another full school year operating in a pandemic, our students, staff, and community continue to shine brightly, and tonight we will celebrate the best of the best. Joining me on stage this evening, helping me to present the coveted Golden Apple Awards, will be the most talented leadership team in the state. Please welcome to the stage with a round of applause my colleagues on our senior leadership team, Tanya, Kristen, and Mike, and our school principals, Kristen, Aaron, Corey, Luke, Christian, Kelly, Matt, Brett, and Andy, our leadership team. Come here first. Come here. Stand here first. Just join me on stage. It's a good group shot. The work is hard, and yet you lead every day with compassion and energy. Thank you for all of your leadership this year. It's been a tremendous year. I really appreciate it. One more round of applause for our leadership team, please. Luke, Kristen, Aaron, Christian, yep. Kelly, you can sit. Just need the four. So, one thing our award show planning team learned from the Billboard Music Awards is that people watching the show in person and on the live stream want to participate. So, a few times this evening, we will ask our audience, both in person and those at home, to influence our show. To begin, we need your help selecting tonight's stage ambassadors. Of these four highly qualified and highly educated principals, we need you to select two of them to present the golden apples to the winners and escort people on and off stage. So, take out your phones and get ready to vote. You can scan the QR code. You could text to 37607. Text Elmbrook to 37607, or you could go to pollev.com/Elmbrook, whichever works for you, and you will see the four options. Option A, Brookfield Elementary's Aaron King. Option B, Tonawanda Elementary's Kristen Olson. Option C, Burleigh Elementary's Christian Pleister. And option D, Fixon Elementary's Luke Sadowski. You can only vote for one, and we will share the results shortly. This isn't real time because our live stream's like 30 seconds behind, so we'll come back to this in a second. But thank you, principals, for your willingness to serve, and we'll call you back up in a few minutes. And now, to you, our finalists, retirees, award winners, presenters, and guests. This night is about you and all of the people you represent across the district. This award show is the culmination of an incredible staff recognition process. In March, 550 staff members received over 1,100 nominations in our 14 award categories this year. Those nominations were reviewed by our Engaged in Excellence planning team, and with input from our school principals, 3 to 6 finalists were selected in each category. Next, we assembled last year's award winners as the Voting Academy, and the Academy voters were given the impossible task of selecting one winner in each category, and were only asked to spread out their anonymous votes across schools. Recognizing that one could never pick the best in each category, our recognition process celebrates all of the finalists throughout the whole recognition process. Each finalist received a golden envelope declaring their finalist status. Their pictures and short bios are featured on our website, and they were invited to participate in this grand awards event with their family and friends. And all finalists and retirees will receive a swag bag as you leave tonight. Don't leave without it. A small token of our appreciation for your work this year. We hope you truly feel that it is an honor just to be nominated. And congratulations to all of you. Tonight's award show would not be as grand without our title sponsor, the Elmbrook Education Foundation. The EEF, led by Executive Director Beth Dobrzynski, raises money in support of student scholarships, classroom and program innovation, and large projects such as the replacement of large band instruments. We're grateful for all the EEF does, and especially for the sponsorship of this awards event. If you'd like to support the foundation, the EEF is hosting its Circle of Friends event on Thursday, May 12th, right here at the Sharon Lynn Wilson Center. More information can be found at ElmbrookEducationFoundation.com. Thank you, Beth, and the EEF for all you do. My first guest joining me on stage this evening is a student at Project Strive, our district's transitional program for students after they complete their high school experience. Megan Oliver was selected to participate in tonight's show for her leadership, maturity, and responsibility. And I am excited to speak with her. Please welcome Megan Oliver. Hello, Megan. How are you feeling about participating in this big award show?
I'm nervous, but as I spoke at the Strive fundraiser, so I have experience in front of big groups.
Yeah, that Strive fundraiser was a big success. Could you join me just a little bit closer? Come with me. There you go. Perfect. Megan, is there one highlight about your experience at Project Strive this year that you would like to share?
I'm a senior at Strive, and I'm graduating soon, a class of 2022. I work at Ingleside in housekeeping in Kingston Woods River and in the water park.
In the water park, that sounds like fun. What have you learned about yourself this past year, Megan?
I am a good leader in morning meetings.
Morning meetings. What teachers or teacher has helped you succeed at Project Strive, and how do they help you be successful?
Mrs. Yanker has made me be a better person. She made the slides for morning meetings.
Yeah, slides for morning meetings. That's great. Megan, I noticed that you're wearing a backpack. Is there something in that?
I am carrying the award winners for tonight's show.
And have these award winners been kept confidential and secure?
Yes.
Do you think I could have those award winners so we can keep this program going?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. Megan, you have just delivered the most important part of our awards program. Thank you for keeping the results confidential and secure, and for helping me host tonight's award show. How about a round of applause for Megan Oliver, everybody? Okay, we are almost ready for our first award. But before we begin, we need to reveal our award ambassador winners. Elementary principals, can you please join me again on stage as I quickly check the results? Well, after thousands of votes, what's 4 divided by 6? With 66% of the votes, our first award ambassador is Aaron King, Brookfield Elementary. Congratulations. And right behind, with a percentage that I cannot calculate in my head, is Luke Sadowski, Dixon Elementary. Congratulations and thank you. So if you can go get ready off stage for your big part in this show, I'd appreciate it. Finalists, here's what you need to know. I'm going to introduce our presenters for each award, who will then come out here on the podium and describe the category, read the finalists, and announce the winner. If your name is called as the Golden Apple Award recipient, we would like you to quickly proceed to the stage up this way and up onto the stage. Receive your congratulations from your principal or senior leader. You'll stand right here in the middle and take a picture with the students who presented. And then our talented ambassadors will guide you off stage and back for another couple more pictures, and then you'll be able to return to your seats from the back of the theater. So once we do this once or twice, I'm sure everyone will get the routine. Okay? So as the great Tom Brady says in every Hertz commercial you've ever seen, let's go. So, like the Academy Awards, you'll find that our award presenters are also award-winning celebrities. As I introduce them, I will share a little about their accomplishments or recognition this year that helped elevate them to award presenter status tonight. Leah Rios is currently the USA National Miss Wisconsin Preteen. Last fall, she was recognized with an Inspiring Youth Award for her work as a peer ambassador for Generations Against Bullying and for performing over 3,000 hours of community service. The verdict is in on Lucia Brewer, and it is guilty of participating on Wisconsin Hills' very successful mock trial team. Lucia's commitment and dedication to this team was most impressive. Please welcome Pilgrim Park's Leah Rios and Wisconsin Hills' Lucia Brewer.
Middle school teachers support the transformational change of their students, from kids to young adults. They build relationships first and always, so that they can ignite a passion for learning. They are smart, compassionate, demanding, and forgiving, all on the same day. The finalists for Excellence in Teaching Middle School are John Kish for Science at Wisconsin Hills, Chris Minchk for Applied Technology and Engineering at Pilgrim Park, Amanda Pacino for Music at Wisconsin Hills, and Michelle Pavletic for Math at Pilgrim Park. And the Golden Apple goes to Amanda Pacino.
This is Amanda's first nomination and first award in this category. Amanda teaches choir and loves to sing. In fact, Amanda will enthusiastically join her students in singing any genre of music, except country music, which she says she just can't relate to. She never liked her pickup truck. Her dog is still alive. Dancing in a line seems far too regimented. And if that wasn't enough, her cowboy boots give her blisters. Congratulations, Amanda!
Nice job, ladies. Good open. Thank you. The list of accolades for our girls and boys swim programs continues to grow. Lucy Thomas is a 3-time state team champion and 9-time individual and relay champion who holds the state record in the 100-yard breaststroke. Not to be outdone, but unfortunately not able to make it tonight, was Stuart Seymour, who helped the Brookfield Barracudas combined boys team to its first ever state championship this winter with first place finishes in the 100 backstroke and 200 medley relay and runner-up finishes in the 100 fly and 400 free relay. The best part of their accomplishments is that they are only juniors. Please welcome to the stage Brookfield East, Lucy Thomas.
Coaches and advisors commit long hours to provide students opportunities to be a part of a team, build lifelong friendships, and demonstrate their skills and abilities. They inspire passion for one's sport or activity and celebrate the success of all participants. Many of our students and teams reach great heights because they were guided by an outstanding coach or advisor. The finalists for excellence in coaching and advising are Van Donkersgood, boys swimming and diving coach, Brookfield Central and East. Brooke Jameson, cross country coach, Brookfield East. Linda Lead, tennis coach, Brookfield East High School. John Vogt, mock trial and tennis, Wisconsin Hills Middle School and Brookfield Central. Reinhardt Zeiser, chess club, Swanson Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Linda Lead.
Linda has been coaching tennis at Brookfield East since 2000, serving as the boys and girls head coach since 2005, where she has had multiple team and individual state champions and many state qualifiers. Despite her long-standing tennis success, Linda dreams of changing her summer advantage tennis camps to paddleball. No more broken strings, players only have to move 2 steps in any direction, long rallies usually involve 3 hits, and games are over in 7 to 10 minutes. Simply heaven. Congratulations, Linda Lead.
The list of possible presenters for the Community Partnership Award was long, because of the impactful services offered by the Everside Health Team to our staff and our families. First grade teacher Cindy Stemper was selected to represent all Elmbrook employees who have benefited from the care received at the Wellness Center. Please welcome Swanson Elementary teacher Cindy Stemper.
Good evening. It is my privilege to invite the Everside Health Team to the stage to receive this year's Excellence in a Community Partnership Award.
While the Everside Health Team did not want to give an acceptance speech, they did want to take this opportunity to remind Stephen, Robert, Diane, Julie, Corey, and Kristen that you still need to complete your follow-up visit to the Wellness Center following the health risk assessment screening in the fall. We need to see you, and we open tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Everside Health has provided amazing health care services to district employees and our families for the past 5 years. By offering high quality, near site health care, the district has been able to spend $13.4 million less than projected on health care, savings that have been directly invested into classroom learning needs. The success of the district's partnership with Everside can be attributed to 2 factors, expert care and personalized attention. From the moment a staff member enters the Family Wellness Center, Karen, Kat, Elise, Leslie, and Kaylee, Callie, make you feel comfortable and cared for. However, it is their passionate commitment to customer service and finding the right healthcare solution for each individual that keeps families like ours coming back. On behalf of my son, Evan, and our entire family, as well as the hundreds of families serviced by the Everside team each year, thank you for your tremendous partnership and unmatched service to our educators and our community. Congratulations to the Everside Health Team, the 2022 recipient of the Excellence in a Community Partnership Award.
Congratulations to the Everside Health Team.
The phrase, "there is no I in team," was never more true as these Tonawanda fourth graders joined together to win a competitive Battle of the Books competition at their school, and then went on to play second in the state elementary division this spring. These girls not only love to read, but will be happy to tell you all about the 20 books they were quizzed on for the competition. Please welcome Tonawanda's Zuri Alvira, Addison Dvorak, Julia McWay, and Susie Salinas.
Often work in teams to lighten the load, solve complex problems, and tackle new challenges. The teams that are being honored tonight reflect a shared commitment to excellence and a willingness to assist one another regardless of the task. They communicate constantly and they are quick to distribute praise to their coworkers and team. Finally, they are highly regarded by their peers and colleagues.
The finalists for Excellence in Teamwork are 4K Team Tonawanda Elementary, Special Ed Coordinators District Office, Custodial Team Dixon Elementary, Custodial Team Swanson Elementary, and 4K Team Brookfield Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Brookfield Elementary 4K Team.
Outside the classroom and wait for the locked door to open and to be greeted by one of the students. This approach worked well until the week the class learned about stranger danger and Dr. Hansen showed up without a principal escort. Well, some stories are best left untold.
Members couldn't make it tonight, so we improvised. Elmbrook has become a dominant force in Wisconsin robotics, and several of our successful teams are represented here this evening. One example is Aman Amjad. and his team has Matt teammates who won the Inspire Award at the State First Technology Competition and placed 26th at the recent World Competition in Houston. Additionally, Aman earned the distinction of a Dean's Finalist, one of three Wisconsin students selected for his leadership and dedication to FIRST Robotics. Presenting solo this evening to another last-minute absence, please welcome Brookfield Central's Aman Amjad.
The district is fortunate to have an engaged community that provides thousands of hours in volunteer service in our schools each year. Volunteers serve in our classrooms, libraries, and offices. They run clubs, activities, and organize events and musicals that provide unbelievable opportunities for students. And most importantly, they share their expertise and their passions to inspire a generation of learners committed to service. The finalists for excellence in volunteering are Amy DiPiazza, Brookfield Central High School, Sue Jacobson, Burleigh Elementary, Sarah Monty and Connie Peterson, Dixon Elementary, Liz Robinson, Wisconsin Hills Middle School. And the golden apple goes to Amy DiPiazza.
Coordinating Central's concessions at nearly every sporting event and activity on behalf of the Booster Club. Amy is always ready to open a stand and make some money. In fact, after the show, she will be selling food out of the trunk of her car in the parking lot. Hot dogs are a dollar, licorice is 50 cents, and popcorn is only a quarter. Get it while it's hot. Congratulations, Amy DiPiazza!
One of the great aspects of this award show is that we celebrate all roles in our district, including our substitute teachers, and for the first time ever, our bus drivers. This year, more than any other, our substitutes were critical to stabilizing our learning environments and allowing us to adapt to human resource challenges that changed every day. For over half of this year, even our senior leadership team was subbing weekly in classrooms with, as you will see in this video, varying levels of success.
One of my most memorable subbing experiences this year was in a 4K classroom. On this particular day, I had 24-year-olds on my own when one of the students started to jump around and let me know that she really needed to go to the bathroom. In a matter of seconds, I decided that the best course of action was to take everybody down the hall to the bathroom and we'd all wait for the one student to go. The mistake in this approach was quickly evident in the level of noise in the hallway, and as it started to grow, teachers came out from their classroom and began shutting their doors because my class was out of control and very loud. When my little friend exited the bathroom, I asked, "Did everything go okay?" And she replied, "Yes, it was just a false alarm." So, as we returned to the classroom, one kind and understanding student told me the correct procedure that they normally use to go to the bathroom, and then said, "Welcome to 4K.
Every time I subbed, I appreciated the warm welcome I received in each class, particularly in one first grade class at Swanson Elementary.
Good morning, Mr. Thompson.
Are you our sub today?
I am.
Mrs. Mattis always says, no matter how good or how bad our substitute teacher is, we need to be on our best behavior.
One of the things I appreciated about subbing was the opportunity to continue daily class routines, especially those that showcased my 1980s dance moves.
Come on, Mr. Thompson. Every morning after announcements, we start the day with a Just Dance video, and you have to participate.
All right.
And I swear this is true, and I'll owe it all to you.
Great,
if you sit this one out.
There were many instances this year when I was in classrooms and everything worked as planned. Lesson plans were shared in advance, technology worked seamlessly, and students were on task and well-behaved. As a sub, those are the days you live for. There was one day, however, in a first grade classroom at Burleigh, when the technology was not working as planned and it took me 15 minutes just to log in. Since it's been several years since I've taught high school mathematics, my go-to substitute activities were a little rusty and not really geared towards six-year-olds. But I had to do something because these students were eager and ready to learn. So together we worked our way through two of my favorite lessons on trigonometry and avid study skills. And I was most impressed with their effort and questions about the content I was presenting. These first grade students were asking things like, "Mr. Serino, how does the polynomial quadratic equation you're describing connect to our single digit addition lesson that we learned yesterday?" Or another one was, "Mr. Serino, does Cornell note-taking strategy originate from Cornell, the city located in central Iowa? Or Cornell University, the Ivy League school that my three siblings attended for undergraduate and graduate degrees?" Ah, only in Elmbrook. Needless to say, after that experience, I worked with the technology team to replace that computer in Ms. Warner's classroom so that the next substitute could simply focus on short vowel sounds in the lesson plans.
After subbing two or three times in the classroom, I asked myself, what kind of an impact am I having on student learning? Naturally, as the head of business services, I ran a regression analysis and found, as you can see it on this chart, the less time I spent in the classroom, the greater the level of student achievement. I verified this analysis with several other charts. And in conclusion, I determined increased student achievement was more important than me subbing in the classroom.
Hi, this is Lisa, substitute coordinator for Elmbrook Schools. May I help you?
Hi, Lisa. This is Matt Schrader, principal at Wisconsin Hills. Yeah, I need someone to come over to teach math this morning. One of my teachers just called in ill, and I've got 28 students ready to learn.
You know what? I'm sorry. I don't think I'm going to be able to help you today. I already have 37 unfilled absences.
Isn't there someone at district office who can help? Like anyone? I don't care what their qualifications are. I just need a warm body.
I got the call, and I'm ready to sub.
Call now and find out about free shipping.
Thankfully, other Elmbrook staff members' substitute experiences were extremely impactful, time and time again. Three individuals in particular have made such an impact that we created a new celebration series on our website to honor their work called Above and Beyond. Tonight, we'd like to recognize those three. Please help me welcome to the stage Janelle Huber, Cheryl Waffenschmidt, and Dan Scott. Janelle's day job is at our district office in a support role for our student services team, but she has proven invaluable in filling in as a special education assistant sub, sometimes 2 to 3 times per week. Hyper committed to meeting the needs of all students, Janelle is calm, reliable, and willing to serve in whatever capacity is needed on any given day. Cheryl's position as assistant to the athletic director has required a PhD in logistics management the past 2 years. COVID protocols, weather, a shortage of PM officials, and transportation challenges impact our teams daily, but Cheryl handles it with ease. A few years ago, Cheryl took it upon herself to earn her bus driver certification so that she could also help transport teams to their activities. Both this year and last, Both this year and last, Cheryl has become the go-to sub driver for teams at both Brookfield East and Brookfield Central when we get in a bind, which lately this spring has been 2 to 3 times each week. Several times last year, Dan Scott stated to others that he found his why when subbing in elementary classrooms. Normally, the director of technology, Dan is naturally drawn to the struggling learner and works tirelessly to make a connection. On multiple occasions, Dan's relationship building with students has led to weekly lunches, book reads, or school visits to stay connected to kids and to make sure all students know that they have a champion in their corner who cares. Ask Dan. Ask Dan about their progress, and his face lights up with pride. We're so grateful to all district staff who have gone above and beyond, but especially to Janelle, Cheryl, and Dan for their extraordinary commitment to our students. While we did not think it fair to include them in the normal substitute teacher category, we did want to present them with a Golden Sub Award this evening. Unfortunately, our tight budget only allowed for one award. So, we are going to need you to vote on tonight's winner. So get those cell phones back out and vote for either A, Janelle, B, Cheryl, or C, Dan. And while we're waiting for the results, we'll have them go back to their seats and we'll call them up to the stage in a little while. But thanks again for your supper. Make sure you place your vote. One small omission in our program, sorry to our three substitute teachers who are being recognized tonight, we noticed that their bios were not included in the program. They are on our website, they will be on the screen, but they're not included in your print program, and our apologies for that. Throughout the year, several of our staff members also earn awards and special distinctions. Signora Lenz was named the Brookfield JC's Outstanding Educator for her work in the classroom, her advocacy for all world languages, and her contributions as the advisor to student council. Jenny Katrichis, the school psychologist at Brookfield Central, was named a Herb Cole Teacher Fellow this spring for her work with individual students as well as her work with student peer-to-peer groups striving to promote mental health and wellness and raise awareness about suicide prevention. Please welcome Brookfield East, Monica Lenz, and Brookfield Central's Jenny Katrichis.
Great substitute teachers set high expectations while being flexible and responsive. Quite often, they sacrifice their own personal schedules to meet last-minute needs. They see each class as an opportunity to support student learning and make a difference in someone's life.
The finalists for excellence in substitute teaching are Rashida Aurora, Wisconsin Hills Middle School, Jill Marie Jansen, Brookfield Central High School, and Paul Jeffries, Pilgrim Park Middle School. And the golden apple goes to Paul Jeffries.
Paul's versatility makes him an extremely valuable substitute at Pilgrim Park. But his accent makes him a man of intrigue with his students. Wait for the next online poll where we will play, where is Paul Jeffries really from? England, Scotland, Australia, or West Allis? Nobody really knows. Jeffries.
According to Principal Gretzmacher, he has worn out a pen approving all of the virtual and college courses Harshman Sira has taken to augment his robust academic education in Elmbrook. Apparently, it's paid off, as Harshman, who is also a GSAFE Youth Advisory Council member, is a direct admit into the University of Cincinnati's College of Medicine's BS MD program scheduled to graduate in 2030. Lucy Irwin is a talented writer who achieved stardom this fall on this stage playing Elle Woods in Brookfield East musical Legally Blonde. Please welcome Brookfield Central's Harshman Sira and Brookfield East Lucy Irwin.
A superior commitment to the customer, deep knowledge and expertise, and an amazing ability to work under pressure with calm and grace. While they do not speak praise, they are often recognized by students, staff, and families as being model representatives of Elmbrook schools. This category is for excellence in service and support.
The finalists for excellence in service and support are Monica Bianco for summer school and assessment coordinator, Ann Shaka, Office Manager of Fairview South, Lisa Giamo, Student Services Assistant at Pilgrim Park Middle School, and Christy Westfall, Assistant to the Superintendent. And the golden apple goes to Christy Westfall.
Public record requests this year, Christy is frequently engaged with the district's legal counsel and now notices that she's displaying attorney-like behaviors in her personal life. When her children ask a simple yes-no question, she responds with a long reply that includes many wherefores and howevers. She references case law during discussions with her husband, and when friends borrow money from her, she rounds up the repayment amount to the nearest $100.
A National Merit semifinalist and co-captain of one of the most successful Beast Robotics teams in history. This year, the combined Elmbrook team won both the Wisconsin and Minnesota regional competitions, earned two design awards, and competed at the World Championships in Houston. As was mentioned in the video, Marissa Roth had a storybook finish to her high school career. An advocate for girls wrestling since middle school, she became Elmbrook's first ever state champion in February. Please welcome Brookfield East Zane Rothy and Brookfield Central's Marissa Roth.
Leaders have great vision and inspire others to be their best. They lead by example and show care and compassion to students and staff. Tonight's nominees are revered by others, deliver on their promises, and work tirelessly to create change across the district.
The finalists for the Excellence in Leadership are Carolyn Hahn, Associate Principal, Brookfield Central High School. Emily High, Teaching and Learning Specialist, Burleigh Elementary. Elizabeth Mullaney, Gifted and Talented Coordinator, District Office. Katherine Ryan, Teaching and Learning Specialist, Brookfield East High School. And Angie Slonak, Teaching and Learning Specialist, Brookfield Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Carolyn Hahn.
I'd like to thank Principal Brett Gritzbacher for all the leadership opportunities he's afforded her this year. Supervising prom, directing parent pickup traffic, embedding herself in the student section at the state basketball tournament, video surveillance of the cafeteria, and wiping down tables and chairs before staff meetings. I couldn't have won this award without you, Mr. G.
Both of our next presenters competed in state competitions in Madison this past March. Fourth grader, Keshav Karun, trailed only his middle school brother at the regional spelling bee competition, advancing to state where he held his own against 54 fourth through eighth graders from across Wisconsin. Middle school student Ava Shack won her regional wrestling weight class and placed fifth, at the very competitive Wisconsin Wrestling Federation state meet. Please welcome Swanson Elementary's Keshav Karun and Wisconsin Hills Ava Shack.
Student services team members support a wide range of needs, from college and career planning to occupational therapy to connecting students and family to community resources. These professionals display excellence in their work by meeting the needs of all students, as well as developing the skills, knowledge, and dispositions of staff.
The finalists for Excellence in Student Services are Nicole Hiller, psychologist at Burleigh Elementary, Jason Lippold, school counselor at Brookwoodies High School, Katie Prestigard, speech-language pathologist at Swanson Elementary, and Heidi Raleigh, psychologist at Tonawanda Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Jason Lippold.
Students declared they were attending the Harvard of the Midwest. After more research, Jason discovered that following an inspirational college talk by Dr. Hansen, several students signed up to attend Dr. Hansen's alma mater, UW-Whitewater, which he often refers to as the Harvard of the Midwest. Congratulations, Jason.
I have exciting news. The results of our Golden Sub Award are in, so I'd like to call back Dan, Cheryl, and Janelle back to the stage to reveal tonight's winner. After an amazing 6.2 million votes, our live stream presence seems to be growing as the show goes on. The winner of tonight's Golden Sub Award is Janelle Huber and Dan Scott and Cheryl Waffen-Schmidt. Hey, congratulations. They're really expensive awards, but don't touch the gold or it'll rub off on your shirts. We really had three awards, obviously, all along, but we just needed to inject some drama into the show tonight. So thanks again for playing along. Congratulations to all three of you. Thanks for going above and beyond. I am proud to say that Cheryl Waffen-Schmidt is not the only Elmbrook staff member who's certified to drive a bus. I completed my training and received my CDL license in November, hoping to inspire others to get licensed and to shine a spotlight on both the need and Go Right Way's amazing training capabilities. We captured some of my experience in this next video.
We had some concerns when Chris Thompson decided that he wanted to become a certified bus driver. And then he shows up in that ridiculous jersey. Well, it was important to gauge his commitment, so we put him through some challenges that other drivers may not have had to go through in their training.
How many of these do I have to do?
One for every student on the bus.
Every day?
Every day.
You want me to clean all the seats on every bus? By what time?
While he may have aced the online test and pre-trip checklist, there were bumps in the road when it came to his behind-the-wheel training that gave us cause for concern.
You're gonna wanna stop at that stop sign.
You meant every stop sign?
Every stop sign.
I can't believe this. Do you want your kids to be late to school? Do you know who I am? Sorry, I'm late for my route. I'll get you tomorrow. It's only a mile walk to school.
You know, I think even his wife has some doubts about him driving a bus.
Oh, I had concerns about him driving that bus. He can't even drive the minivan into the garage without hitting the wall.
We always thought we had the best trainers in the business, but now we know that our training program is so good, even an Elmbrook senior leader can do it.
GoRightWeight.com if you're interested. We're still looking for drivers to close out the year. Our next two presenters spent a considerable amount of time this spring under the sea. No, it wasn't part of Elmbrook's new marine biology curriculum, but rather it was through their starring roles in Brookfield Elementary's production of The Little Mermaid Jr. as Ariel and Prince Eric. Welcome to the stage, Kathy Donahue and Max Fahrenholz.
Safe and stable transportation system was something that many of us took for granted until this year. We are extremely grateful for the partnership with Go Right Way and the extraordinary efforts by all Go Right Way team members to provide busing services to our school communities. A student's bus driver can make all the difference in a child's day at school, whether sharing a welcoming good morning on a boarding, returning a lost coat or lunchbox to school, or wishing students best of luck in their evening activities. Our bus drivers are the best of the best. The finalists in excellence in transportation are Brian Brown, Tonawanda Elementary. Sharon Heilman, Burline Swanson Elementary. Javon Zeray Oliver, Burline Elementary and Hillcombe Park Middle School. And the Golden Apple goes to Brian Brown.
After witnessing Brian's acting talents in the recent Elmbrook Senior Leader Training video, the Go Right Way leadership team is considering a name, image, likeness contract with Brian to capitalize on his newfound stardom. They also gave him a bonus for hazard pay as compensation for having to ride in the bus that Chris Thompson was driving. Congratulations, Brian Brown!
Our middle schools offer a wide range of co-curricular activities and experiences, from cricket club to full musicals. Rageshri Bharat took advantage of a new opportunity this year and was Elmbrook's first ever 3-minute film festival winner in the category of Best Film from Younger Ones for her film Pest Peeves. Aryaman Goswami is a leader in the National Junior Honor Society with strong character and a desire to make his school a better place. Please welcome Pilgrim Park's Aryaman Goswami and Wisconsin Hills' Rageshri Bharat.
Teaching assistants serve in many roles across the district. They support learners with a diverse range of needs while demonstrating deep care and concern for all students every day. This year, they model flexibility and versatility, filling in for absent teachers, helping substitutes navigate the curriculum, and supporting students' transition in and out of the classroom.
The finalists for the Excellence in Teaching Support are Sherry Bergren, Elizabeth Eaton, Martha Elson Kujak, and Nina Ordway-Mendon. And the winner of the Golden Apple is Sherry Bird.
Sherry was nominated as an award finalist with her learning support team in 2019, but did not reach the pinnacle of a Golden Apple. Now that she has been awarded a Golden Apple as an individual, she realizes her teammates were probably holding her back and she should have let them go. There's no I in team, but there is an I in Golden Apple winner.
To connect with our next two presenters on LinkedIn tonight so that you can one day say, I knew them when. Cynthia is the Distinguished Young Woman of Wisconsin winner, Herb Cole Scholarship recipient, and she led the BC mock trial team to its first ever state championship with the most outstanding attorney awards in school history. Henry is the defending state tennis doubles champion, founder and CEO of a bus optimization software company, and has leveraged several launch experiences to master his presentation and public speaking skills. Please welcome Brookfield Central's Cynthia Liu and Brookfield East's Henry Irwin.
Our high school teacher nominees are experts in finding creative ways to engage students in their learning. They have an open door policy, giving freely of their time in order to meet the needs of all students. They challenge, inspire, and guide students as they prepare for life beyond Elmbrook.
The finalists for Excellence in Teaching High School are Ryan Kramer, English, Brookfield East. Matt DiPello, Social Studies, Brookfield Central. Melissa Grazer, Special Education, Brookfield East. And Renee Smith, Math, Brookfield Central. Yeah. And the Golden Apple goes to Melissa Grazer.
Melissa was described by one of her colleagues as a humble champion for children. Another teacher celebrated a behavior program she created based on Spy Ninja to incentivize a struggling learner. Of course, a program based on intense situations, detective work, stealth, and hacking was all too familiar to Melissa as a special education teacher. She normally just calls that a Monday.
Woo! Melissa couldn't attend tonight, so we filled. We made it work. Our next three presenters, Jane, Benjamin, Kevin, please come to the stage with me, please. One of the great opportunities we have in this show is to put our premier high school's valedictorians on stage together. And this year we have three students as Brookfield Central celebrates co-valedictorians. Listen to this list of their collective accomplishments. All three are national merit finalists. Kevin is the Wisconsin Upper Michigan Key Club Governor and Cole Scholarship winner. Jane plays in the Milwaukee Youth Symphony and is coxswain with the Milwaukee Rowing Club. Benjamin is taking Spanish 5 and 6 at the same time, and together they have taken a combined 54 college or AP classes in their 4 years of high school. Additionally, I've learned that Benjamin and Kevin both work at Chipotle, which may be the key to future valedictorians. My kids are applying there tomorrow. Let me grab a microphone here. I just want you to tell me what you're gonna do next year, if you could. Just introduce yourself and tell us what you're gonna do next year.
Sure. Hi, I'm Benjamin Kim. I go to Brookfield Central High School, and my colleague valedictorian is Kevin New over there. I'll be attending UChicago, and I'll be part of the class of 2026.
Hello, my name is Jane Atkinson, and next year I will be attending the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where I will major in chemical engineering.
Hi, as Ben introduced me earlier, I'm Kevin, and next year I'll be attending Brown University to study computer science and economics.
So, please help me congratulate Brookfield East 2022 valedictorian Jane Atkinson and Brookfield Central 2022 co-valedictorians Kevin New and Benjamin Kim. And they will now be introducing our Alumni Excellence Awards.
Good evening. It is my privilege to invite Damian Bookman and Captain Tom Bento to the stage to receive this year's Alumni Excellence Award.
After learning of the award designation, both men were very honored. However, Captain Bento quickly noted that there must not be any high school GPA requirement for the Alumni Award. Damian commented that he gave the commencement speech in 1996, but graduated in 1997. In response to those statements, our planning team members have verified that both men did actually graduate from our high schools and are eligible for this prestigious award.
In 1 month, Jane, Ben, and I will join 600 of our classmates and graduate from Brookfield Central and Brookfield East. We will move on to college, have incredible experiences with students from around the world, and pursue careers that may not even exist today. However, with all that lies ahead of us, we will never forget the experiences that shaped us as we grew up in Elmbrook schools. Like the two alumni we will celebrate this evening, we hope to pay it forward, impacting our community and the world with confidence, knowing that we were prepared by the best teachers in the state of Wisconsin. Tonight, it is our pleasure to honor alumni Damian Bookman and Captain Tom Bento.
Damian Bookman is a 1997 graduate of Brookfield East High School. He is a two-time survivor of an extremely rare childhood cancer, and he took his passion for enabling those living with disabilities and made it his mission. Damian is the founder and CEO of the Ability Center, a nonprofit organization that has focused on providing inclusive athletic activities and making local parks more accessible. Damian has endured 34 surgeries, including 22 knee replacements. He is a starter on the Wisconsin Thunder wheelchair basketball team, and most importantly, is a proud husband and father to his three amazing sons. Damian continues to share his story of hope and perseverance with students in the Elmbrook schools. And tonight, it is our privilege to honor Damian Buckman as the 2022 Alumni Excellence Award winner.
Captain Tom Vento is a 1986 graduate of Brookfield Central who served in the Brookfield and Elmbrook communities throughout his law enforcement career. Member of the first freshman class at Brookfield Central, Tom began his career with the town of Brookfield Police Department at the age of 19. Served in the Elmbrook Police Department for 4 years, eventually joined the Brookfield Police Department in 1992. During his 33-year career, Tom served in many different roles, finishing as captain of the patrol division. In 2002, Tom was diagnosed with cancer and battled 3 occurrences of the disease over 12 years and through 15 surgeries. Throughout his service to his community never wavered. Tom and his wife are proud parents of 2 Brookfield East graduates, and it is our honor and privilege to recognize Captain Tom Vento as a 2022 Alumni Excellence Award winner.
As we close in, one second. As we close in on the end of our award show with 2 more categories and closing remarks from Dr. Hansen remaining, we have one more interactive experience for you. So get out your phones again one more time in the theater and at home and help us decide how long should Dr. Hansen's closing speech be tonight? 3 options. Option A, 90 seconds. Option B, you're looking for a 5-minute speech. Option C, I'm having so much fun, I want this night to go on forever. Go ahead and vote. Voting will close shortly as we let our online participants vote as well. So, thank you for your input this evening in Choose Your Own Award Show. I'd also like to take this time to give a quick shout out to our Engaged in Excellence planning team. So this recognition process, and in particular this event, does not happen without the tremendous effort of several members of our district office team. And as I say your name, if you're in the audience, please stand up or step out so we may acknowledge your work this evening. Aaron Kokta and Eric Hagen from our communications team, Dan Scott, Christy Westfall on the microphone in back, Pam Casey, Lisa Gennaro, our food service team of Caitlin Harrison, Laura Barrett, Sarah Leatherman, and Trisha Erlakis. Please give these people a round of applause. So I would guess that even a simple game of cards may get pretty competitive in the Haugen household. Both sisters are top-rated junior golfers, striving to follow in their older sister's success. Additionally, fifth grader Brooklyn earned a spot on the National Honor Roll for the Noetic Math Contest, and eighth grader Peyton is a student senate officer and Hope Squad member. Please welcome a talented, dynamic duo, Erlei Elementary's Brooklyn Haugen and Pilgrim Park's Peyton Haugen.
We are fortunate to attract the most talented teachers in our region to our great schools. A few of our new educators, however, set themselves apart through their ability to connect with students, influence their peers, and teach with wisdom and experience that is well beyond their years.
The finalists for excellence in teaching by a new educator are Tiffany Bianco Murphy, Special Education, Wisconsin Hills Middle School. Scott Hestiken, Special Education, Brookfield Central High School. Brianna Kessler, Second Grade, Tonawanda Elementary. Carolyn Cusell, Occupational Therapist, Swanson Elementary. Morgan Sternad, Special Education, Burleigh Elementary. Courtney Stoll, Kindergarten, Brookfield Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Carolyn Cusell.
Carolyn is often seen in the halls of Swanson, coaching students who are riding a three-wheeled bicycle for muscle development and strength training. The cycling has worn a path into Swanson's hallways, and so Carolyn has requested funds for a cycling velodrome to be built on campus and proposed naming it after her retiring principal, Corey Harton.
In our schools, even an elementary dance titled Tiaras, Tutus, and Ties is an opportunity for fourth grader Olivia Peterson to collect food donations for the Waukesha Food Pantry. Additionally, it's never too early to start competing in robotics as third grader Elizabeth Black and her teammates who placed fourth at state in the robot game would attest. The bottom line, if you're sitting around waiting for something to happen, these two girls are going to quickly pass you by. Please welcome Dixon Elementary's Olivia Peterson and Burleigh Elementary's Elizabeth Black.
Each day is a new adventure for an elementary school teacher. They must teach with enthusiasm, respond to different abilities to each learner, and instill confidence and a love for learning in every child. A great elementary school teacher can make a lifelong impression, and tonight's nominees have demonstrated their ability to make a difference in the lives of their students.
The finalists for excellence in teaching elementary are Angelica Groff, second grade at Burleigh Elementary, Heidi Hudson Merritt, special education at Tonawanda Elementary, Katie Johnson, second grade at Brookfield Elementary, Julia Richardson Kroll, second grade and third grade at a virtual classroom. Jessica Smith, special education at Swanson Elementary. And Chris Swanson, music at Dixon Elementary. And the golden apple goes to Angelica Groff.
Year is anything is possible. While most people believe this originates from her growth mindset and belief that her students can do anything, it really stems from her home life where Angela and her husband Chuck, both Brookfield Central Lancer graduates, raised three boys who have all attended Brookfield East High School. What more proof do you need that anything is possible in Elmbrook?
As we prepare for closing comments from our superintendent, I'd like to say thank you again to our planning team, food service team, onstage ambassadors, and our presenters who all made this award show a great success. Thank you to those who watched tonight's event via live stream and participated in our three live voting experiences. Unbelievably, we did get a winner in that last poll. 17% of you, though, before I announced the winner, did say, I want this night to go on as long as possible. So I'll just have you note that. However, the winning, if you will, poll option was 90 seconds or less. So, following the close of the show, we'd like to have all Golden Apple recipients on stage for a group photo, if you could, please. And all finalists and retirees are reminded to pick up their swag bag, which will be in the lobby before you leave. Superintendent Hansen, the results are in, and you have 90 seconds. The clock starts now.
Chris, meet me in the office tomorrow morning, please. This brings us to the conclusion of the 7th Annual Engaged in Excellence Award Ceremony, where we honored staff from Elmbrook who will retire at the end of this year, along with recipients of the Engaged in Excellence Awards. I want to thank the Elmbrook Education Foundation for their generous support of this evening's program, and congratulations to everyone for their honors tonight, all well deserved. I'd also like to thank our school board for their support. Our board is represented this evening by Treasurer Jin Sun, Board Vice President Gene Lambert, and Board Member Jen Roskoff. To the 1,100 nominations representing 550 members of our team, congratulations on being nominated for these awards. We appreciate all of your efforts to make our district a great place for kids and
please
colleagues.
Please conclude your remarks.
To our finalists of the Engaged in Excellence Awards, congratulations and thank you for going above and beyond. I would like to ask the retirees to please stand one last
please
time.
Please conclude your remarks.
This group of educators represents a total of over 350 years of service to this great profession and this amazing school district. Thank you for all that you have done for our kids, for our colleagues, and for our entire community. Your legacy is the thousands of lives you have impacted. You are giants in this field. Thank you for everything you have done for this community. On behalf of the school district and the entire Elmbrook community, I wish you good luck and all the best as you begin a new chapter.
Please conclude your remarks.
Thank you for another great evening. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Please conclude
your remarks. Be well.